Minister, Your Excellencies, Chiefs, Generals, Admirals, former Chiefs, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, good morning, everybody. The participation of such distinguished guests is a great honor for the Hellenic Armed Forces and ensures the success of this year's conference. I would like to thank you, especially the Hellenic Air Force and those involved for the participation in this, for this event and for the 7th consecutive year execution here at the Hellenic Air Force Academy, the premier institution for developing the officers that will lead the Hellenic Air Force in a high demanding operational environment the next decades. During the last years, we observed rapid changes around the globe with the creation of new political poles along with growing number of non-state actors. Additionally, there are local factors, especially in the Eastern Mediterranean region, like the new energy policies development and the migration issue that need to be addressed and thoroughly analyzed in order to understand their influence in the decision-making process and the formulation of new defense policies. The importance and the major advantages of the air power is that it has the ability to identify, oversee, and neutralize the strategic concerns of gravity of any adversary without having to directly defeat the opposing military forces. At the same time, it incorporates remarkable operational advantages like flexibility, immediate response, and large operational ranges. For this reason, our effort is to address the broad-ranging issue of the role of the air power domestically and in NATO's deterrence. So our intention is the conference to act as a catalyst to emulate a debate among senior military staff, academics, and industry partners, in order to provide, especially to NATO and EU allies, leadership with innovative ideas on potential actors that may be required in this area. In all cases, in order to achieve maximum results, it is essential to conduct a thorough strategic analysis, taking into account all affecting aspects, including the political, diplomatic, economic, and social perspectives. In this context, I hope during this conference, the audience will develop their understanding of the ideas behind the way we should think and analyze the strategic and operational environment in order to take advantages of the air power support operational characteristics. The ultimate goal of this process is to integrate the appropriate policies to our strategic planning and obtain decision superiority that will ensure the achievement of the security objectives. In this regard, I would like to express my gratitude to all speakers and participants, especially those who traveled long distances to be here. Ladies and gentlemen, we live in a region with multiple conflicts and challenges where Greece, beyond any doubt, is a pillar of stability and security. The challenges we accept are strong, and the management of the situation requires caution, determination, and thus we are maintaining powerful armed forces with full operational capability and strong deterrence power. However, the cooperation between countries who sharing common goals and similar defense and security risks and concerns is necessary. In the light of the above, for one more time, I'm particularly pleased to the presence of our allies and partners. We have an excellent opportunity during the conference for cooperation and exchange of views on defense and security strategic issues of common interest and future consideration and development. I wish you all a very fruitful and rewarding conference. Thank you.